Hello and welcome back. We're heading into Act Two, but before we begin, we have two things to say. I know you've just come back from having some snacks, from having some drinks, but please remember that we cannot consume all that stuff in here as it is to maintain a relationship with respect with the theater. Please remember that. And if you have any lost belongings, including right now, if you've lost anything, or at the end of the show, including these black and amber glasses that someone left behind, please come see us after the show. And please remember, we do not allow flash photography in order to not distract the actors when they are performing. We do really hope that you enjoy and you keep enjoying this performance. And we've put in a lot of effort and we hope that you enjoy. Thank you.
Look who got beached. There's something different. Don't tell me. I'll decipher it myself. Aha! Your hairdo. You've been using the dingle hops.
She's got legs, you idiot. She traded her voice to the sea witch and got legs.
No. Not your beautiful pipes.
Yeah, see? Not a sound.
Hurts me to say this, kid, but that was a lousy swab.
What would a father say? I'll tell you what a father'd say. He'd say he's gonna kill himself a crab. That's what a father'd say.
She's just got 3 days.
3 days to what?
Make the prince fall in love with her.
And to prove it, she's got to kiss him.
Well, the prince, hey. Well, to snag yourself a prince, you gotta learn a graceful way of perambulating.
Nope, she'll do no such thing.
Sure she will. Come on, up you get. What's this? Giving up so soon? Mm-hmm. That's not like you. You gotta have a little gumption, a can-do kind of attitude. Take it from a bird who knows. You look at me, you see this face. In terms of beauty, I'm a basket case. And as for style and savoir faire, well, I guess there ain't a whole lot there. But although perhaps it makes no sense, I strut my stuff with lots of confidence. 'Cause though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I've got. I got positivity. I got positivity. It gives me the zam and the zow and the yaddle-addle-addle. That's why I walk with a wiggle in my waddle. 'Cause once you heard that word, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positivity work for you.
Positivity? What? There's no such word.
Sir, there is. It's in the dictionary, right between popsicle and prehysterical. I've seen it work miracles. So with the bip and the bop and the ba-ba-boo, you can flip and you flap till your wish comes true. The tip is to tap into something that you believe. 'Cause with the zig and the zog and the zizzer z. There ain't nothing you can't be. You see, it's really your prerogative.
You simply can't think noggative.
Then there's you just sitting there, smack down flat upon your derriere. If that's the way you wanna be, well, you might as well be shrubbery. And you stand right up and dust your seat. Stand real tall upon your own 2 feet. Enjoy your trip and make mistakes. You've got what it takes.
Whoa.
Whoa!
You can't do. So let that positricity. You can get that positricity. You can get that positrinity. No, positronomy? Positronomy. Wait, what is it?
Positivity.
Positively work for. You.
Miss, are you all right? You seem very familiar. Have we met? Yes, of course. You're the one I've been looking for. Please, you must tell me. What is your name? Excuse me, you don't speak English? Sore throat? I'm sorry, you don't speak at all, do you? For a moment, I mistook you for somebody else. Whoa, what is it? Are you hurt? No, you need help. Whoa. Okay, a bit dizzy, aren't we? I've got just the remedy. A warm bath and a hot meal. Come on now, the palace isn't far. You'll be fine.
Bravo, Ariel, that's what I call reeling him in.
This is gonna get me in real hot water.
Can you believe that guy? What a crab! And now you know that word, there ain't nothing you can't do. So let that positivity work for you.
Majesty,
have you found her?
We've searched everywhere. We found no trace of your daughter.
Well then, keep looking until you do.
Yes, sir.
Well, I never meant to wish her ill, Daddy.
I know.
And if she never comes back, and I'm forced to sing her solo?
We won't stop looking until we find Ariel.
Thank you, dear child, thank you. As if the loss of your mother weren't enough.
For
like kelp. Perhaps it was a horrible shipwreck. We'll never know the truth. She won't speak. Not a single solitary word. Do what you must to make it presentable. A scrub in the tub, proper frock.
Are you getting your strengths, dearie?
Can't help but wonder what she must be thinking. I give a furthing or two just to hear her thoughts.
Oh, just a look. It's like I'm in a storybook. Oh, it's bliss. I dreamed that it would be somewhat, but not like this. Look over there. Oh my God, how very odd, and what might they be? Something splendid, maybe. Look over here, could you bust? Isn't it just bedazzling, dazing, utterly amazing? Gazing round, it's like to die. Just seeing it feels so good. I'd scream if I only could. I'd hoped and wished and wanted so to be here. Wished and prayed and planned it to a T. Prayed and wow, just look, it's really me here. Walking around, strange as it seems, somewhere beyond my wildest dreams. Look at her there, looking around, won't make a sound.
Just keeps on gawking, weird how she's not talking.
Look at her stare,
lucky miss,
chosen like this to stay for then.
What does he see in her?
Hush now, girl, she's simply shy.
Just picture the table chat,
one-sided if even that.
Ladies, in two short nights, the prince will be holding his contest, and young ladies will be singing themselves silly to win his heart. Tonight, he will savor some quiet.
I'd hoped and wished and wondered what I'd do here. Wished and prayed and pictured what I'd see. Pray and wow, just look, it's really me here. Look at it all, look how it gleams, lovely beyond my wildest dreams. Look, it's him, so handsome and refined and slim. Sweet, sincere, magnificent from head to toe.
Look at it all, hall after hall, perfect as you could please here. Marvels galore, and even more, gee, did I mention he's here? And if who knows, all of it goes past even these extremes. Just look at me, and you will see someone beyond her wildest dreams.
Good evening. Well, now I'm the one who's speechless. Hungry?
Attention, attention. La menu pour des scores. Scargo? Tuna, tata, holy mackerel, manchinette. Set the cushion, finish. Les poissons, hee hee! With a cleaver, I hack them in two. I pull out, put inside, and I serve with a fried. God, I love little fishes, don't you? Here's something for tempting the palate. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet. Then you slash through the skin. Get a bit of slice. Then you rub some salt in. Ah! Cause that makes it taste nice. Sutilos, I am Miss One. Sake blue. What is this? How on earth could I meet such a sweet little succulent crab? Quel dommage with the loss. You belong in the sauce with some flour, I think, just a da. Then I'll stuff you with bread. It won't hurt to be dead. You surely be lucky you are. Cause it's gonna be hot in my big copper pot. Tout de mon bon sang. Au revoir!
Time, hasn't it, Prince Eric, since we've dined in the company of such loveliness?
Usually it's just me and Grim. He's gonna look across the table at my ugly mug.
Why, yes. The shower certainly worked its wonders. She's groomed for a groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy, easy. My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Don't tell me she's fond of tobacco. It's a pipe, I don't blame you. It's an antique meerschaum from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Yes. Very amusing. She just suddenly knows how to make you smile. Shall we?
A delectable treat, but I'm sure you'll just love a Lisbon bon appetit.
Les poissons, les poissons, ooh la la, here they are. Say bonjour to our friends from the sea. Fish pâté,
fish pâté,
it's a fish.
Slightly toasted and roasted and steamed.
Tossed in the blender and tenderly creamed.
Dish after dish like you wish to have dreamed.
And now for the grand finale. La pièce de résistance, a delicacy by calling. You won't find in the restaurants a taste but the taste of taste buds. But that certain je ne sais quoi. Voilà.
Thank you.
If it's... You're a quiet girl in a noisy world. I'm just a prince who'd rather be a simple sailor. We're both fish out of the water, you and me. What is it? Did I say something wrong? Ah, who needs words anyways? A smile says just as much sometimes. Ah, nimble on your feet, aren't you? Dancing beats small talk any day. Why, sure, it's the way your feet smile. Or laugh. It lets you say so many things. Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, go on, like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. Yes, see how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step is one step closer to saying what you feel. Once the music hits you, inhibitions fall away, and you find that you're expressing things your voice daren't say. Don't be afraid, let go. Soon as you surrender, what's inside will sweep on through, as the boundaries between us disappear. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to talking loud and clear. A dance is like a conversation, except you never need to make a sound. And once you've begun, you speak as one, give and take, back and forth, round and round. Do you hear that? I'm sorry. I haven't been myself lately. It's after midnight. I should let you get some sleep. Good night.
Out of the frying pan and into the fire. The things I do for you, girl. Okay, now I know what I should do. I should march right back home to your father so you can be... miserable for the rest of your life. It's true. I got no backbone. All right, child, then. We got to make a plan to get that boy to kiss you before it's too late. You got to bat your eyes like this. And you got to pucker your lips like this. That's good. Now, you put those two together. Smile. And you got that boy in the palm of your hand.
Entirely too close for comfort, boys. One night and they're already dining together.
Then dancing cheek to cheek.
I should have known that there's only one thing more powerful than my black magic.
The power true love?
No! Teenage hormones. Seems the little tart is off to quite the start. Just one night in Princey Boo is wallowing in bliss. Think of what they'll do. My sunset number two.
What?
Idiots, go up and block that kiss.
Yes, your Regimus.
In the meanwhile, a poor, proud, happy. Bet he's wondering where his baby's been.
Where it's sick.
So upset.
Not happy. Soon he'll guess, then oh yes, all the fun'll begin. Daddy and his angel, how they're gonna hurt. Once our plan is in full flow, once that kiss goes amiss, then the world will be mine. What she's had, then her dad will be caught on my line. Then a spell from the shell, and up to heaven they'll go. La 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 la.
No girls ever dared join me out here, too afraid they'd muddy their shoes. But not you. Peaceful, isn't it? Not another soul for miles and miles.
Nothing's happening.
All morning they've been on horseback, then a picnic, and now this. And not so much as a peck on the cheek.
So, how about this weather, huh?
Oh, 24 hours left. And then I'll be married off. Poor Ariel. She'll be deep sixed.
We got to do something, and quick.
But what?
We got to create the right kind of mood.
Aha! Something romantical. Candlelight. And shampoo.
Nonsense. It don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here. Percussion. Strings. Wind and moonlight. There you see her,
sha-la-la,
sitting there across the way.
Sha-la-la.
She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her.
About her.
And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna
kiss the girl.
Yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do. Possible she want you to. There is one way to ask her.
Kiss the girl.
Kiss the girl.
Don't take a word, not a single word. Go on and kiss the girl. Sing with me now. Sha la 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 la, my oh my. Look like the boy too shy. Ain't gonna kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame? Too bad he gonna miss the girl.
You know, I really ought to know your name. Maybe I could guess. Alexandra. Annabelle? Beatrice.
Ariel. Her name is Ariel.
Ariel? Ariel. Hey, that's kind of pretty. Okay, Ariel.
Now's your moment. Floating in a blue lagoon. Boy, you better do it soon. No time will be better. She don't say a word and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl. La 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 la, don't be scared. You got the moves, you better go on and kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, don't stop now. Don't try to hide it. How you wanna kiss the girl? Sha la 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 la, float along and listen to these songs. Don't say kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, music play. Do what the music say. You gotta kiss the girl.
Ariel, are you all right?
Sebastian, what was that?
Lightning?
From underwater?
Must be some kind of freak storm. Anyways, we ought to get back to shore. It's my birthday tomorrow, and we're hosting a contest. Grimsby wants me married before sunset. Or else...
So sorry.
We'll just have to keep waiting until she shows up or someone finds a...
Merciful Triton, I pray that you'll keep calm.
Useless crab! I entrust my youngest daughter to you, and what happens? I ought to have you cracked. I ought to have you shelled!
No, he almost was, Your Majesty. It was all for Ariel.
And you should be embarrassed of yourself, too. Now what kind of tragedy will take place?
A tragedy involving the sea witch, to be exact.
These two eels came and they took her straight to the sea witch and she traded her beautiful voice for a pair of legs!
So you're saying Ariel bartered her voice away to become human?
By this time tomorrow, that child could be giving up her very soul.
Her soul?
And all to that wicked sister of yours.
I think it is time I fix things once and for all.
Else you require for bed. Very well then. Must catch 40 winks. Big day tomorrow. Prince Eric must choose his bride. Oh, come, child. Mustn't look so blue. The secret to happiness. We mustn't wish for impossible things. Good night.
If only you could know the things I long to say. If only I could tell you what I wish I could convey. It's in my every glance, my heart's an open book. You'd see it all at once if only you would look. If only you could glimpse the feeling that I feel. If only you could notice what the dreams I can't declare, the needs I can't deny. You'd see them all at once if only you would try. All my secrets, you would learn them. All my longings, you'd return them. Then the silence would be broken.
What is it about her that's so wonderfully, impossibly familiar? Why do I feel dizzy in a way I've only felt but once before? How come when she looks at me, it seems like time stops moving? Almost like the way it did that day upon the floor. But her voice.
Speak of any princess in the land. How can a little mermaid compete with that?
If only I knew how I'd make him see the light. If only it was up to me, this all would turn out right. And if I only could, I'd tell you what I'd do. I'd simply wave me claw and make your dreams come true. And wouldn't that surprise you if you only knew?
How could I have pushed her to the point of having no one left to turn to? It's been 2 days and I don't know where she has gone.
I hear it.
Listen to it, clear as can be. You know I may when I hit my high C. Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything, everything, everything? Well, I'm a scholar up to law. I've been brought so is second to none.
So, one of these lovely sounding princesses must match the music to your heart.
I wish I could say yes, but no, she's not here.
Well, you'll be the death of me, dear boy. What am I to do with you? The sun has nearly set, and your birthday is soon to be over. Please, you must choose someone. Perhaps, if we steel ourselves, and we take another look.
Ariel?
Heavens, child, no, you mustn't.
Shh. Wait, Chris. Be quiet and listen. Go ahead, Ariel.
Poor sweet child. I did so hope, dear Eric, that you'd find love somewhere in this room.
Perhaps I have. I've just been too blind to see it.
What? She didn't utter a sound.
No? Well, that's funny, because I heard every single note, as clear as a bell. That must mean something, old boy. That's it, that's the voice!
Oh, this is most unexpected.
Tell her the contest is over. Tell her she's too late.
Why, look, such a gorgeous sunset!
Hello.
Where you belong. Say goodbye to your prince, your pretty dress, your satin pumps. You're mine now, mermaid.
The rest of your days as her slave.
Plucking the barnacles off of her back.
Ursula!
Brother, darling, you're right on cue.
What have you done with my daughter?
Nothing. She's done it all to herself. Trading her voice away, and for what? Human heartbreak.
Give her back to me!
Not on your life. It so happens that your daughter signed a contract. Even drew a little heart above the eye.
No.
Is it binding? Goodness, yes. Unbreakable, unless...
Unless...
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes, perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Sign the scroll and set her free. Or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone. The mute little hatchling... Drowning in her own sorrow, with no voice left to cry out your name. Well, I'm waiting.
It's not my soul you're after, it's my power.
Which would you rather be, the king of the sea, or a father to his little girl? Finally! And now you poor unfortunate souls, time's up, you're through. Now the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole. All the magic of the trident is shell in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shoal. Now see for yourself how banishment feels, you poor black magic now.
My voice! The spell is broken!
Give me back my shell!
If it breaks, you die!
You believe that? After all the lies he's told you!
Lies? What lies?
He told you the world above was hideous. And what was it instead?
It was beautiful. Beautiful beyond compare.
He'd say anything to turn you against the prince and his kind. Why, he'd even say that they murdered your mother.
Wait a minute. If humans didn't kill her, then...
It was you, wasn't it? All this time I've been blaming them and it was you!
Who? Why? Why I couldn't hurt a minnow!
Forgive me. I've caused you such terrible worry. Thinking of only myself. Not you. Not my sisters. Not this place. The only place I ever truly called home.
I'm the one who's at fault, Ariel. Cursing humans when all along...
There's goodness in people, Dad. I know it. I've seen it.
Even when I couldn't. I'm proud of you, Ariel. Mother would have been too. Somehow, in the blink of an eye, my back was turned. You grew. You love him very much, don't you?
It's what she wants, Your Majesty.
Belong to his world now.
Thank you, Dad. Thank you so much.
Tomorrow at sunrise, we search again.
Your Majesty, she's lost.
I will not rest until I've found her.
Look, sire.
Ariel! Could it be? It's been your voice all along, hasn't it? Who are you?
I'm King Prey.
This is my father.
Your Majesty. At last, I found someone who makes me eager to seize the future and claim my birthright as king. But if I slip out to sea sometimes, I don't think she'll mind, because she'll be right there next to me, keeping us both on course. With your permission, sire, I'd like to make her my wife.
My permission? Ariel can speak for herself.
Yes, Eric, yes!
Wrong after bedtime. That's my deal.
I presume you are the young man's father.
Heavens, no. His Majesty is long gone. I'm his guardian. Nothing more.
Well, I wager he'd be proud. Of both of you.
Yes. Eric is my shining achievement in a dark world.
Congratulations to the both of us.
Thank you. And to you.
Thank you.
stay and never say goodbye. If only I could make time stop, believe me, I would try. But fathers have to learn that daughters have to grow. And if you truly love them, you must let them go.
And oh, I love you so.
Tall tales and superstitions, huh, Grim?
So, that's King Triton, and she's his daughter?
Does that upset you?
No. No, heavens, no. I'm just glad she's royal.
And now at last, love has surpassed each tribulation. Mermaid and man finally can join anyone. Now they can smile, walking the aisle, here at their wedding celebration.
Sailing forward,
standing steady, starting flight
from who we were. Now they can be who they're meant to be. Now they can gaze on a new horizon.
There's still some things that we need to say as a team, actually, and I will start saying first and first most, please, a little bit of time. We're going to be done soon. But the first thing is to say that, as you can see, there's a lot of magic happening here, right? This is a place for magic. So all this magic is possible because not just the passion and commitment of all this crew. But I told them that this is a place to have fun, to enjoy, and the passion and commitment has been just over the top. But at the same token, I would like to say personal thanks to the theater team. So I would like to ask to join me at the stage, Angelica Gonzalez, please. Hector Polanco, please. Hector. ¿Dónde estás, Hector? Hector. Hector Polanco, por favor. Y, como no, Mr. Gonzalo Jorquera. And last but not least, the great Claudio Flores. Thank you so much, everybody, for coming. My pleasure.
All right, I just wanted to, we have so many people to thank, and on behalf of the NIDO activities team, I mean, wow, what a magnificent, memorable, inspired, absolutely joyous performance we got to witness tonight, earlier today in front of the high school yesterday. Just a credit to we want to say thank you and a credit to the entire cast and crew, the entire people that stood behind this performance. It took so much teamwork, so much coordination. I see sports all the time. I've seen nothing like this in all of my time here at NIDO and all my time in international schools. It's a credit to what you did day in and day out. I don't know if you know, but we made a pretty significant change to the theatrical schedule this year. The musical, it was a semester one production. It really raised the bar. It demanded so much from our actors, our performers, and everyone behind the scenes. You all didn't just meet expectations, you soared past them. I also want to say it's very special when we get an opportunity like this to bring the entire NIDO community together. It looks like we have half of the elementary school here today. We have the entire high school here, and the ovation, the standing ovation, it brought tears to the eyes. It makes me think of a Maori saying about expectations. It is, you always shoot for the stars, because even if you miss, you land on the highest mountaintop. And I would think that you guys would all agree that tonight, they brought the stars to us. One more big round of applause, and thank you to our tech team, our directors. Here's Miss McKenna.
Thank you so much for supporting our high school program. Our students are amazing, and so are our teachers. I'd like to also, in addition to our theater team, I'd like to call out Miss Zuzu, who directed our show. Bernie, our choreographer. I'd like Max and Ofir to come up also, who helped direct this show. Antonia Corona, who helped make all of these beautiful costumes, design and make. Alison Toni, who also helped make our costumes today. And Paula Montecino, who also helped with our set. We have a gift from our theater parents, who have something for each of you here in order to honor your dedication to our students, to our high school. And we want to honor that tonight. We also have a gift from the students that they've made for each and every one of you. And it will be coming by the end of the week. They want to give it to you at a special time. And so we want to thank everybody. And Miss Zuzu wants to honor also some very special people.
Okay, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so it's the tradition that at the end of the show, we get all the seniors together because this is their last show. And so Oli, Mouse, Nico, Martin, I'm sure I'm missing someone. Who else? Esete, can we please give you, Logan, of course, Logan, sorry. Who else? Yeah, Fran, sorry. Es que this has been a long process, but, you know, like Triton says, parents have to learn to let their kids grow, and this is what we're doing today. And Max, sorry. Yeah, and so this is it. Parents, you should be proud of your children. They're amazing. Aquí we have the talent. And can you join me as well to sing Happy Birthday to Mouse? Yes. So this is going to be very special. Can we go? La Misusu doesn't do singing, but I will try. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday
to you.
Happy birthday, dear Mouse.
Happy birthday to you.
Thank you for coming. I hope you saw everybody in the thank you list, but you know, this is a big teamwork, the tech team, you know, the art teachers, Ryan, Ross, Neil, Sofia Kim, Scott, everybody has, you know, the costume, Paula Montecino, Alison with all the mothers. Please, mothers, stand up. People that, you know, yes, por favor, hours and hours of sewing. And so this is it, yeah? Thank you so much for coming. See you next year.